In this lesson, we will cover how to create a pull request using GitKraken clients integrations with hosting services like GitHub, GitLab, Bitbucket server. And with it, you'll be able to quickly create a pull request using drag and drop, drag and drop using the left panel options, and you'll have a pretty good idea for how to start collaborating with your other team members. One thing that I'll say is that while we have multiple integrations, some are more built out than others. For example, GitHub is probably the most built out integration since their API has a lot of connection points. And so that will have its own lesson where we'll cover all the benefits of using the GitHub integration. But there's a lot to be had with all of the other integrations as well. For this sample repository, I will be using, so you see, I have a Bitbucket repo. For today's example, I will be using a GitLab repository and I'll be creating a pull request. But in case you don't have any of the integrations set up yet, I just click this plus icon here to open a new tab. And now your version might look a little different, but you should see, which of your integrations are already connected. And if any of these are not already connected, you'll have a shortcut where you can jump straight to the preferences section where you may connect said integration. So, for example, for Bitbucket, let me disconnect real quick so you can see. But let's say your Bitbucket connection looks like this. It's not connected. You can click Connect to Bitbucket to follow the flow and have those set up. We do have lessons that walk through how to set up each of these integrations. And I recommend taking a look at those if there's one that catches your eye. Now, GitLab is set up and ready to go. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to my GitLab repository. And I do have this branch here, Directors Cut, or Director Cut. In this repository that has a change that I wish to have merged into main. So you may have a different workflow, but a common workflow is that you have a feature branch or a bug fix branch. You go ahead and write your code, make your commits, and then you move to make a pull request so that someone else can review it, provide comments, give you feedback. You go make your changes, and eventually you land somewhere where the pull request is approved. And the code is merged into the target branch. Now, in GitLab's case, they do call pull requests merge requests, but they're functionally pretty similar. And the way to create a pull request in GitKraken client is to drag and drop the branch onto the branch you want to merge into, well, create the pull request against. And you should see an option to start a pull request to origin or to the target branch from where you're coming from. Now, you may also see an option. Let me pause because this branch already exists on my remote. And the way that I know that is I see my GitLab icon next to this computer icon, which the computer icon represents local branches. The remote icon represents the remote branch, and both are present. So both of these branches point to the same commit, both locally and on the remote. If you don't see the remote icon, my point is you might see a prompt to first push and then start the pull request. So GitKraken client just puts it all together. It's like, hey, do you want me to do all of these things at once? Usually the answer is yes, and that's what you'll see when you go to make that option. So I'll click to start the pull request, and you'll be brought to a form that gets pre-populated based on that drag and drop that you just did. So for example, we know that we're coming from Director Cut. We want to merge into main, or this is a pull request or a merge request in GitLab's case, to hey, I'd like to have this code reviewed and eventually merged into this target branch. Now, GitLab's integrations supports adding an assignee and labels. I don't have any labels on this account, but you could do so as well. You could add those if you'd like. And before I hit create pull request, I do want to show you one other place where you can create a pull request with any of our integrations, and that is from the left panel. So you may see that there's a left panel section for pull requests. When you hover over the left panel, the header for pull request, you see a plus icon. Click on that to create the form. And you can see here I have multiple integrations connected, so you have the ability to create pull requests under different integrations depending on what remote hosting service you're using. In my case, though, I'm using GitLab, but you see here that I have to then pre-populate, which branch we're coming from versus when I perform a drag and drop. All of that is pre-filled in for me. Okay, so Alex, can you please? So let me write a message here. You may have, if you have any internal best practices that you'd like to go by, I definitely recommend going by that. This is just for an example. I'll go ahead and set myself as the assignee and I'll click to create the pull request. So there you go, the pull request now exists. And with the GitLab integration, we do show you some, we list all the pull requests underneath the pull request section. And you do get this when you hover over the pull request, you get some quick information about the PR. The thing that I'd like to show you is that if you then go to this menu, you have some actions that are available to you. And the one that I'll call out is that you have the ability to view the pull request directly on GitLab.com. And you can also check out the branch that is associated with that pull request or merge request in the GitLab's case, right? That might come in handy because you can have a pull request from your collaborators listed here as well, as long as you have them added as remotes. So if you add the remote, you should be able to see their pull requests. And that's a great, easy way to jump to whatever branch happens to be the topic of that pull request. But in any case, let's click the option to view the pull request on GitLab.com. And here it is. Here's the merge request on GitLab. And I can, you know, if you prefer to jump into here because you want to take specific actions, I know that within each service, they might have some features that are pretty nice. Or you can, you know, or you can just, with the GitHub integration, you can do some extra fancy things as well. But in the case of these other integrations, that's one nice feature is that you can copy the link to the pull request, of course, but then also view it directly in the browser so that you can continue the conversation and hopefully get that merge request approved and merged. All right, so that's a quick primer on how to create a pull request using the various integrations that are available through GitKraken Client. Hope that was helpful, and we'll see you in the next video.